We're really very sorry, but we can't be bringing you Jeff Bartley's new open stage. This is Noise Party. Noise Party is hijacking this program tonight. So this is not new open stage, it's Noise Party. Keep that in mind. Noise Party.
Noise Party.
Well, have I ever got a treat for you. Of course, I realize not everybody in the world is the world's biggest fans of Dredd, Foole, and The Din. But I was poking around in my archives, and I discovered that not only do I have their seminal show at Johnny D's recorded January of 1986, not the Johnny D's in Somerville, but the Johnny D's that used to be in Alston about 12 years ago, or 11 years ago, I also have their final show, their farewell performance, recorded at the Rat. And strangely enough, for the 1986 show, they are backed by basically what is the first lineup of the Volcano Suns, as far as I can tell. Unless it's the second lineup, which it could well be. See, I don't always have these facts straight. However, on their farewell performance, they are backed by what I believe is one of the original... I don't know, one of the original lineups. I'm not quite sure. Dan Ireton, Ward, Jeff Wigand, Kenny Chambers, and Williams are the backup band. So I think what I'm going to do is present the farewell performance live at the Rat first, and then Dreadful and The Din recorded live at Johnny D's, and follow that up with the Volcano Suns also recorded live at Johnny D's on the same day. But I wanted to be sure to get that that seminal performance of Dreadful and The Din in there. Now, I have to warn you that the kiddies may not like this. It's rather loud and obnoxious, actually. But nevertheless, of course, there is an interview with Dan Ireton, Jeff Wigand, and Kenny Chambers at the end of this tape, but I don't think we're going to have much to do with that. So anyway, just because I can, I will tell you what the songs were at that performance. Some of these are things that I've never heard them play before, and of course they'll never play again since they've broken up. Number one is This Is It, and then Strange. I think it's an excerpt. 16 Tons is number 3, number 4, Criminal, number 5, Put Down, number 6, Slack, number 7, Should Have Known Better, not the Wire song, number 8, Paralyzed, number 9, Alone, both really great songs, number 10, This Is Your Shit Opportunity, number 11, Can't Stand It, and number 12, I Feel Nothing. So, and you'll get a real bang out of these tunes, I'm sure, but, anyway, geez, I've rattled on enough. I've got a tetanus shot, and boy is my arm sore, totally sore. In fact, wow, I mean, I didn't feel anything yesterday, much like Dreadful and The Din, Dan Ireton. I felt nothing, but now, of course, I'm really starting to feel it. I mean, I sort of slept on my shoulder all night long. Well, no, actually, I guess I didn't, but I would have. Maybe I did, because it's really sore now. But that could be the tetanus shot. I can barely lift my arm. Oh well. This too shall pass. I also got a TB test. I'm being eaten alive by psoriasis. It's as hot as hell. Of course, you know, this is coming to you on August 13th, but it is in actuality. Dare I reveal this information? Only June 18th. That's because we got to do these things way in advance. And even so, 2 months lead time is barely even enough. Anyway, so, yes, so I'm going to bring to you Dreadful and The Din. I'm sure Dan wouldn't mind. And he's a big pal of mine, see. I interviewed him a while back. It was actually a 100-page interview, which I had to edit down to about 5 pages. Now, your great film directors cut 300 for one, but they ain't got nothing on me. Just waiting for these tapes to rewind. Boy, are you in for a treat. I know it's kind of gauche. It's kind of gauche to tell you what's going to happen before it happens, but you're going to like this. I think as much as you like the farewell performance recorded in 1988, you're going to. If you stick through, if you manage to make it through that, then you're definitely going to stick around. Going to want to stick around for the 1986 show recorded live at Johnny D's, because that is perhaps the finest, Dredd Foole's finest moment. I just hope that the tape quality is such that you're not embarrassed to play it for your friends. Now here's the other thing too, and I gotta tell you about a little bit about this before we finally proceed a good 5 minutes into our presentation. The tape quality on these is not the greatest, and in fact, part of the motivation behind this whole project is to preserve these tapes before they finally bite the dust. Many of them are over 10 years old and recorded on inferior cassettes to begin with. However, no more excuses. Dredd Foole in the Din, farewell performance, live at the Rat. May 22nd, 1988. Thank you.
Actually, I don't want to just borrow it. I want to keep it. Bring it up. Only Marshall.
Anybody got an amp that John can keep?
Watchtower, Princess Star. How's it going?
Oh, holy night, the answers are
above.
I want to live. I want to live. I want to win.
Thank you.
Ron, turn on the synth drums, will you? Alright, let's get the synth going back there. Let's do it. New direction. Right now we'd like to do a song that was written by the Pet Shop Boys. We've adapted to our own thing. We're just that kind of band. We adapt to our kind of thing. This is dedicated to Seanette O'Connor, Michael Cudahy, and his sister. I've got a line on you, babe. Oh yeah, I got a line on you, babe. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah. There must be somewhere out there. Yeah.
opportunity.
Great.
are not as ready as I thought. God, that was such an exciting beginning, too. Ha! I built it up. I could tell your adrenaline was like right at the top. Shit, I'm fucking up. Let me try it again. Ladies and gentlemen! The hardest working man in show business. The amazing Mr. Please, 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 James Rattle and the Famous Flames.
PCP boys.
PCP.
I don't know where that goes. Holy shit. All right, smoothly.
Woman Dan live at Johnny D's, and this will probably be the only other thing that we hear tonight. If I have any room at the end, I'll probably fill it out with an interview. Dreadful in the Din, live at Johnny D's, January 29th, 1986. And I think you're going to like this one. At least I hope you do.